My name is Rosanna Deerchild. I am from the Opeponapewin Cree Nation in northern Manitoba. I'm Cree. I am the host of Unreserved, which is a radio show on CBC Radio 1, Sirius XM 169, and Native Voice 1, which is on the other side of the Metis line, currently called America. We're also available on podcast. I love Indigenous story. I live, breathe, witness, love it. Right now, I am reading Eden Robinson's second book in her trilogy about Trickster. It is called Trickster Drift. In the second book, we are following young Jared to Vancouver, where he is going to school. However, he cannot leave the magic behind. So right now, he's being pursued by ghosts, his father, Weejit, who is the trickster, his auntie, who might be a monster, we're not sure. We'll find out at the end of the book. And it's just an amazing, amazing read. It's this combination of magic and reality where there is no line, no wall. It's all just right out there in the open. Most recently, we explored what it means to be Métis. Who is Métis? What does that mean? What does that mean within the context of Canada? And what history are we missing? So we explored things like, what is scrip? What was road allowance? And how did Métis practice spirituality? Those things might seem really small, but in the bigger context of the identity of Canada and the identity of Métis, it is so critical for us to know all of our history, not just parts of it. So that was one thing we just did. And we just came back from Iqaluit. So we also just went to visit the Inuit and figure out how they're holding on to their culture, reviving things like throat singing, reviving things like tattooing, but still trying to forge a future for their young people, forge a future for Nunavut, and continue what is Inuit who have been on that land since millennia. So I'm looking forward to bringing that to the Canadian public. Libraries saved my life when I was a child. I was really bullied as a young Cree geek, nerd, Indigenous nerd. I had big glasses, I had braids, I was skinny, I was tall, I had big feet. And one day I was running from a group of bullies and ran into this building in my small town. And I kind of tumbled in and I looked up and there was this woman looking down at me and she had the glasses on and she had the bun in her hair. And she's like, what are you doing here? This is a library. What's a library? She told me what a library is and introduced me to the thousands of books and the thousands of stories and the many places that I would go and discover myself and my own voice and my own story. So libraries are big, small, everything in between for me.